Hello dear student, this is Dr. Agnes John Karat. Today we'll start with museum study of group Protocordata. We'll begin with general characters of Protocordata. Protocordata means primitive chordate animals. Protocordata includes all the small sized exclusively marine primitive lower chordate animals. In these animals, notochord is present, exoskeleton is absent, and cephalization is not seen. Head, skull, jaws, vertebral column, and appendages are absent. True coelom is present. These are enterocoelic organisms. Pharynx with permanent gill slits and endostyle is always present. This pharyngeal organ coats itself with mucus using cilia. Endostyle assists in filter feeding mechanism in protocordate. Heart, if present, is without chamber, and blood without red blood corpuscles, and that is the reason in these organisms blood color is not red. They have protonephric type of kidney. Sexes are separate or united. Reproduction asexual as well as sexual. Development is indirect through free swimming larval stages, and examples are Balanoglossus, Rhabdopleura, Hermannia, Salpa, and Brachiostoma. So we'll begin our practical session with the study of Balanoglossus. Let us learn general classification of Balanoglossus. Balanoglossus belongs to phylum Chordata. Whenever you are studying the classification of any organism, students always remember you should understand the reason why it is included into a particular class or a particular category. It is in phylum Chordata because it has notochord, triploblastic organism, and coelomic organism. Group is Protocordata because it is small marine organism. Cranium is absent. Subphylum is Hemichordata. Notochordata, short, confined to proboscis, soft-bodied coelomate organism. Class is Enteropneusta. Why? Because it has a worm-like body with numerous gill slits. Two rows of cilia are present. Family is Tychoderidae because it is a family of acorn worm. Body is divided in proboscis, collar, and trunk, and genus is Balanoglossus. So this is the general classification of Balanoglossus. So this is diagrammatic representation of the Balanoglossus. Body is simply divided into proboscis, collar, and this is the trunk region, which ends into the anus. Posteriorly, it ends into the anus. Balanoglossus is tubiculous marine organism commonly known as acorn worm. It is found in shallow waters between tide marks along the coast of warm and temperate ocean. It may be concealed under stones, seaweeds, or excavate its own burrows in the sandy or muddy bottom. They live in U-shaped burrow about 50 to 75 cm deep. Body is soft, elongated, worm-like, and cylindrical, having ciliated surface reaching a length of 10 to 50 cm. The body is unsegmented and divisible into proboscis, collar, and long trunk region. Proboscis is anterior most, short, conical, club-shaped body part, also known as protosome. It has a thick muscular walls but hollow inside. Its cavity or coelom opens to the exterior. Collar is also known as mesosome, which is short, muscular, and cylindrical part. Its anterior flap-like or funnel-like margin is called as collarette. The collarette encircles permanently open wide aperture, that is mouth from ventral side. Collar encloses a pair of coelomic cavities that opens by a pair of collar pore dorsally. trunk is also known as metasome. It is posterior longest part of the body. Trunk has mid-dorsal and mid-ventral superficial ridge lengthwise and lodges corresponding nerve and blood vessels. Trunk is divisible into anterior branchiogenital region, medial hepatic region and a posterior abdominal region. Branchiogenital region shows presence of a pair of genital wings formed by internal gonads and brachial groove having numerous paired gill slits arranged into two rows. Hepatic region shows presence of double rows of hepatic cecum. Alimentary canal is straight and anus is present on posterior end of the body. Sexes are separate and fertilization is external. Development is indirect through Tornaria larva. This is balanoglossus in its natural condition. Second organism from Protocordata is Herdmannia. Let us learn about general classification. It belongs to phylum Chordate, group Protocordata, subphylum Urocordata, class Acidacea, family Pyridae, and genus is Herdmannia. Herdmannia is marine, solitary, benthic, sedentary form which is commonly known as sea squirt. It is found attached to the rocky bottom by a broad base or embedded in the sandy floor by its extended foot. It is commonly found in shallow waters all along the Indian Sea coast, Pacific and Atlantic Ocean. Color of the body is pink in fresh specimen while yellowish brown in preserved specimen. The body is laterally compressed and somewhat oblong or rectangular in shape with attached end slightly narrower than the free end. So here in the diagrammatic representation we can see this foot part of the body and this is the body proper. And these are the two apertures. One is brachial aperture and another one is atrial aperture. Body is covered by a test and is divided into two parts like body proper and foot. The animal is attached at its posterior ventral end by a large, rough, leathery foot which often has foreign particles adhered to it. The body proper at anterodorsal or free end has pair of short cylindrical projections called as brachial and atrial siphon or funnels. The brachial or oral siphon is smaller, about 1 cm long and directed outward, which bears brachial aperture or mouth or incurrent opening. The atrial or cloacal siphon is larger, about 1.5 cm long and directed outwards, which bears atrial aperture or excurrent opening. Blood vascular system is open type. Respiration occurs by brachial sacs, but the test also assists as accessory respiratory organ. This organism is hermaphrodite. That means both type of gametes can be produced in one single individual. Fertilization is external and indirect development through free-swimming tadpole larva is seen in this organism. Next organism is Petromyzon. Let us study the general classification of Petromyzon. It belongs to phylum Chordata, subphylum Vertebrata, division Ergnatha, class Cyclostomata and genus is Petromyzon. Here it is a diagrammatic representation of the animal Petromyzon. You can see body is simply divided into head, trunk and tail region. This is the head. Mouth is suctorial. Pair of eyes are present. External gill slits are present without operculum. and this is the trunk. There are two unpaired dorsal fins are present. This is the anterior big dorsal fin and this is the posterior dorsal fin. This is the tail region and it is a caudal fin. Life cycle of Petromyzon include two phases. The first phase is amosid, which is a larval phase and fish-like adult form. Amosid or larval phase is found in freshwater. It is sedentary and filter feeding organism. Adult lives in seawater and is a parasite on fishes, turtles, etc. It clings to the host by its strong suctorial mouth and removes bits of tissues with its rasping tongue. Adults have elongated eel-like body, which is divided into three parts, not so clearly demarcated regions. These are head, trunk and tail. Tail is laterally compressed, whereas head and trunk are cylindrical regions. Body is molted greenish-brown in color. Upper surface is darker, whereas lower surface is lighter. Body is without exoskeleton, soft and covered by slimy secretion of epidermal glands. Two unequal median dorsal fins, first and second, are located near the posterior end. Tail is surrounded by caudal fin. Upper lobe of caudal fin is continuous with the second dorsal fin. The fins are supported by thin cartilaginous rods, the fin rays. These rays are fused together at their bases to the membranous sheath that surrounds the notochord and neural tube and help to strengthen them. In the diagram, we can see the suctorial mouth of Petromyzon. Paired appendages are absent in this organism. It swims near the bottom of salt or fresh water. While moving upward in a strong current, it darts suddenly forward and clings to rocks. In autumn, adults usually move to the rivers for spawning in spring, after which they die. That means for reproduction, adult Petromyzon travels from marine water body to the river water body for the reproduction purpose. They do not feed in river and utilize accumulated subcutaneous fat for their nourishment. Breeding takes place in the spring. Thank you.